Welcome back to Steve Robb Reviews. Today, we're starting a project, a new project from my camp. If you take a look at that thumbnail there, you could see that's the side of my camp, and you see a little door up there. Well, I'm going to put two 100-watt solar panels to cover that door opening. Now, I talked about this on my channel before. I'm going to put another door on the far side of the cabin. This one here, the Best Resolve, a couple of more solar panels, and I'm going to show step by step exactly how I'm going to do this, what the idea behind it is, the planning, and I'm not going to be completely exact on everything because, well, I got to leave a lot of the information, you know, to your own demise. Yeah, because sometimes what I'm doing will not work with what you're doing. This is a pretty unique project, and we're going to start off with the solar panels here. And I specifically buy these style of solar panels. I have no affiliation with this company. I just buy their products, you know, off Amazon. And well, as far as I'm concerned, they're built pretty heavy duty, and they'll be just an exact fit for what I want to do. Now, I have 400 watt array at my cabin already. I'll be adding 200 more watts, and we're going to get into this right now. I'm going to show you the panels, and I'm going to show you the first thing you should do when you buy some panels that a lot of people don't do. And let's get to it right now. Okay, so here's the two panels. One is still in the box, one I've taken out of the box. And I just like to show you here, the two panels come into this cardboard box with a carrying handle, and everything is going right back in the way I got it, and to transport it up to my place in Norton, Ontario. So let's just take a look at this here. Now, these are not cheesy panels. These are really good, heavy-duty panels. And it's not cheap. I have seen some where the frame is so thin. These ones here I really like. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you exactly how I'm going to fasten this to the wall, because I got to take that frame out that you see on the outside of the building and of the door. And then I'm going to mount this over top. It's going to be quite unique. I'm going to bring you in stages at a time. And the first thing that we got to do when you buy a brand new panel is make sure it actually works. So let's plug it in and let's see if it works. Okay, so all we're doing, we got positive, positive, negative, negative. I just put the leads in there. And even with the fluorescent lighting in here, 14.3. So let's start the project right now. I'll take the foam off away from around the panel, and I'll show you what I have in store to make this actually work. Okay, so this is the first part that I have to do, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to show you exactly the parts that I'm using. And I'm going to be using these riv nuts. They're 1/4 inch. They come in different sizes. I'm going to use the 1/4 inch. That's all I need. And I'm going to drill through the aluminum into here. And now, of course, this is just a demonstration piece. This is 1.5 inches, 1/8 aluminum. And what I'm going to do is, you see the bolt here. So this is just going to bolt on. Now, let's just take a look at the idea of having two panels beside each other, right? You got to have two panels beside each other. I'm going to have one piece of aluminum. So I'll make three holes identical to the piece of aluminum. Now, this aluminum, these are 20-inch wide panels, so I'm going to have a piece of aluminum angle 40 inches long. And let's just go to the picture of the door on the side of my cabin. Let's go to that first. So I want to imagine I got to take that frame out. Now, you can see that that door is old and rackety. Okay, so what I got to do is I got to take that door out. And then I'm going to have 40 inches of aluminum on the bottom underneath
the door frame, and I'll screw that to the frame first. Then I'll put the two panels on, match it up to the frame on the top, the same aluminum frame on the top, and screw that in. Now that's going to be quite a feat. I'm going to have to rig up a couple of little interesting things. I'm going to show you how that happens next summer. But if you can just imagine, that door is 43 inches tall, the frame, and 35 wide. So what I'm going to be finished with is the solar panels are 41 inches long. I believe they're 41. So with the angle iron, it's going to be 44. And we're going to have it overlap the door on the sides and be pretty close to the size of the frame on top. I got some interesting framework to go around this. I've already got planned, but just imagine that that's the way it's going to be, and it's going to be all opened up on the backside, so you can have access to the control panel on the back of each solar panel. You have to have access to them because inside there is a diode, and if that ever goes, well, you don't want to have to dismount it from the wall, right? This way here, it's so easy. There's already a hole there when I'm finished, and I'll have access to the backside of the solar panel to work on and wire it all up. Okay, so we're back at the solar panel here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring you back after I've attached this. I'm going to attach three of these riv nuts, drill through the aluminum angle, and that is going to be the foundation for me mounting this on the wall up at my camp. Now, I can take everything apart, put these back in the boxes that they came in. Easy to transport, right? So let's get to it. Well, we're back at the panels, and what I want to do is I want to put evenly spaced three fastening points, which would be the riv nuts, in there, and that's going to secure it on the top and the bottom. So let's go over to the workbench here, and I'll show you what I got so far. On the workbench there, we have the two pieces, one for the top and one for the bottom. And if we just take a look there, we could see where I've got the holes. One, two, three for one side, and same on the other. And I just got a small little pilot bit. And I'll bring you back when I show you how the setup is for actually drilling the holes and corresponding to the solar panel so that the riv nut fits exactly in the same position that I'm going to put a quarter inch bolt to tighten it down with. Okay, so this is the setup. I put the other piece of angle on the bottom because, you know, this wood is not exactly that straight, right? So you could see all the holes there, and I'll show you on the top. I got these big long clamps going from one end to the other to hold the top piece of aluminum angle on there. A couple of clamps to hold it tight so it's not going nowhere. Same on this side. Don't crank these down like crazy or you end up breaking your panel. And got the pilot holes all here ready to go. All I have to do is just start the holes with the drill, and then take all the material away, and then drill the holes all the way through and put the riv nuts in there. So I'll bring you back when that's done. Well, let's just take a look at some of the tools that I used to get this done to the point where, well, I'm pretty much almost finished with working on the solar panels for now. But this is the riv nut setter. Awesome. Works okay, I think. And just need some of these tools, a little bit of a reamer to ream out, because I used aluminum and aluminum is great to work with, but you have to actually, you know, ream the outside edges or you have all kinds of burrs. Now, this here is 25/64, which sets a 1/4 inch riv nut. I went with steel. You can use aluminum if you want, but I find it way too soft. I like to put the steel in on this particular application. So I start off with a smaller bit, work my way up, and these three here are for the spot where the 1/4 inch bolts go in. Now this is a 1/4 inch drill bit here. Just start off a little pilot hole, and then I moved on to 5/16 because it's hard to get everything perfectly lined up, right? So you gotta have a little bit of space. So let's go over to the solar panel and we'll take a look and see how it turned out. Okay, so this is what the ends look like with the riv nuts in, and you could see how everything lines up. And of course, what I did with mine was I made sure I put markings, you know, like 1, 2, 3, 4, and put them on the solar panel and on the piece of aluminum angle, because you don't want to get this stuff, you know, mixed up, turned around and everything else. So that's this end here, and you can see how that goes on there, and I'll bring you to the front here and show you what that looks like. Okay, so there it is there. And if you wonder what the black lines are, well, I had to just mark that because this is where it's going to go into the exterior of the end of the cabin wall. And so I still have to drill some holes here, but I'll have everything all ready to go. So when I get up there, so I can take this off now, I can take all these out and just leave the bolts in the riv nuts, put them all back in the packaging, and away we go. Well, that's it for the solar panel build in this particular part of the series. The next part, we're going to go on to the electrical hookups. I like to sub everything out ahead of time, so when I go up there, it's just plug and play. Now, I'm not going to buy any store-bought items, except, well, I'm going to hook up an ammeter, and I'm going to design a couple of boxes, because the price of boxes are just nuts right now. So, I mean, I can build these boxes for a lot cheaper than, well, than you can't even buy them in the store. You know, they're hard to find. So, especially designed for what I want to do. So many times when you're building stuff like this, well, you have to design it for your own particular build. But I'm going to show you the two electrical boxes that I'm going to design myself and build, and the reasoning behind them, installing an ammeter, and that's pretty much it. So stay tuned for the next part of this series, and I hope you find this interesting. I don't know how many people out there do this kind of stuff with solar, but I find it quite enjoyable, and this is how I do it. Maybe not the exact same way that you would do it or a professional would do it, but I'm not a professional in anything. So thanks for joining me here today. Come back again next week. If you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe, and stay tuned for part 2.